in Belle.
I thought it was Beauty and the Beast. Ow!
Now, for your safety, we have emergency exits located to stage left. We have two in the back. We got one to stage left. And we have one, of course, to stage right.
Please silence all electronic devices at this time, because this is the 18th century France and they don't exist.
There is absolutely no video recording or flash photography.
Now sit back
and enjoy the show.
Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen there was no love in his heart, and as punishment, she transformed him. Spell in the castle and all who lived there. of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return, by the time the last petal fell, the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell deeper into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
My heart!
there are no pictures.
Well, some people like to use their imagination.
You know, Belle, about time you got your head out of those books and paid attention to more important things.
Like you?
Exactly. The whole town's talking about it. And besides, it's not right for a woman to read. Soon she'll start getting ideas and thinking.
Gaston, you're positively prime evil.
Why, thank you, Belle. Now, what do you say you and me take a walk over to the tavern and take a look at my trophies?
What do you say we don't?
Oh, come on, Belle. I think I know how you feel about me.
You can't even imagine. Gaston, please. I have to go inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool. You need all the help you can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah. Don't talk about your father that way.
My father's not crazy. He's a genius. Papa.
Some genius.
What's a genius?
How, Bob?
Now listen, Lou. I want you to go into the woods and see if you can find me the healthiest, biggest deer you can get.
Not the woods. Anything but the woods. You know, I hate the woods.
Just get me a deer for my wedding feast.
But I hate the woods. It's dark, and it's spooky, and there's bugs and spiders!
I'm fine, but I can't for the life of me figure out why that happened. This stubborn piece of... Ow!
Papa!
I'm about ready to give up on this junk.
Oh, you always say that.
I need this. I'll never get this bonehead contraption to work.
Yes, you will, and you'll win first place at the fair tomorrow. And become a world-famous inventor.
You really think so?
You know I do. I always have.
Well... we better get cracking. This thing's not going to fix itself. Yeah. Where do I put that dog-headed contract?
Papa.
So tell me, what time you found today?
I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Well, they take me away to wonderful places where there's adventure and mystery and romance and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
My daughter odd? Now where would you get an idea like that?
I don't know. It's just that, well, people talk.
They talk about me too. No, I'm not odd or you. No family ever same. Except for an uncle who, well, maybe let that pass. And all you say and do, you couldn't make it plain. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are blessed.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are a common herd, and you can take my word. You are unique, fresh, de la fresh. No matter what you do, I'm on your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot. No matter what.
No matter what they say, you make me proud.
My invention shows the world out there one day just what we've got. No matter what. Now some may say all fathers just exaggerate.
That every daughter's great.
You are.
Calls
out all the stops to praise him, and quite rightly. No matter what the pain, we've come this far. I pray that you remain exactly as you are. This really is a case of father knowing nothing. You're all I've got, no matter what. Now, what do you say we give her a try?
All right.
Okay, stand back. Here we go.
It works!
It does? It does!
Papa, you did it! You really did it! Tomorrow, I know it.
Who knows? Maybe I will at that.
Oh, I almost forgot. I made you a scarf for good luck.
Now I know I'll win. We'll get out of town and travel to all those places where I got the book. Well, I'm off.
Goodbye, Papa.
Bye, Belle.
Be careful.
Invention, so simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design will be my old age pension. That is providing I can find the fair at all. I must have missed the sign. I should have paid attention. That's not a nightingale and not a mating call.
My eyes to see, or is this a man? Is there
Oh, well, hello. All right, this is going on far enough. I'm in charge here, and...
Coming through. How would you like a nice cup of tea, Beth? It will be up in no time.
Oh, yes, please.
No tea, Hughie, here all night, no tea.
There you are.
That's just what I need. Oh!
I think I scared him, Mama.
Babette, you're always trying to make me jealous, but it's not going to work this time.
Hey, what about you? With Simon?
Jacques.
Misha.
Pierre.
Ronnie.
Oh, Ronnie.
Lumiere, listen to me. Do you have any idea what the master will do? 1, 2, 3. If he finds out, 1, 2, 3, 4, we let a stranger in.
Calm yourself, Garsman. The master will never have to know. As I was saying, he is bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we hide?
No. There is absolutely no reason to panic.
Lumiere's right. There is absolutely no reason to panic. May I borrow this?
There's a stranger here! A master! Allow me to explain. Said gentleman was set upon my rules.
Opportunity to say I was against it from the start.
Who dared to disobey?
Oh dear!
You have all betrayed me!
Who are you?
Maurice.
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods.
You are not welcome here.
I'll just be in my way.
It's hideous, isn't it?
Oh no, I wasn't.
You've come to stare at the beast, haven't you?
I was merely looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay.
Will you be a extenuous. With great drinks of galore.
Inconceivable.
Each built 6'4".
Unbelievable.
Each one stuffed with every guest on leave.
I'm not hearing this.
Keeping house with pride.
Just incredible.
Each day gratified.
So incredible.
And you are part of this idyllic scene. Rustic hunting lodge. My latest kill, roasting over the fire. My little wife massaging my feet, while the little ones play on the floor with the dogs. Oh, we'll have 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, well, strapping boys like me.
Imagine that.
I can see that we will share all their love and pride. We shall be.
Look at us. Look at you.
What about
that?
insufferable. But every day you become a little more inflexible, a little more wow, a little more ticked off.
Please, the stupid comments.
At least we're not as far gone as the others. You know what happened to Michelle?
She always was the big octopus, and that's exactly what she's become.
How about the thing you put the drawers near the works? Oh, and poor Jean-Claude.
You do?
Jean-Claude, he's not too bright, dumbass.
A brick?
The whole wall.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall?
Yes, that's him in the kitchen, behind the stove. And you know Jean, the houseboy.
That really mouthful of bootlegger. I never liked him. He's always grumbling at the master's feet.
Well, he's a doormat. It's happening faster with some of the others, but we are not far behind. As every day passes, we will all gradually become saints.
But why did we have to be dragged into this whole spell business? It's not like we threw that poor old beggar woman out on our ear.
No, but are we not responsible too for making him so hideous?
I suppose so.
All I know is he'll eventually melt away to nothing. My only hope is the master will break this spell.
Hold on, old man, you've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
It's a girl.
Yes, of course, I can see it's a girl.
It's a girl! Mademoiselle!
Now, Mia, we do all the talking.
Yahoo!
As head of the house, I should be most of the talking. Just a word.
Since this girl is going to be with us for quite some time, we might want to offer her one of a comfortable room, you know.
You didn't let me say goodbye.
What?
I'll never see him again. And I didn't even get to say goodbye.
I'll show you to your room.
My room. But I thought...
Do you want to stay in that dungeon?
No.
Then follow me. This is your home now. You're welcome to go anywhere you'd like, except the West Wing.
Why? What's in the...
It's forbidden! You are never to step foot there! Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes!
This is your room. I hope you'll be comfortable here. If you need anything, my servants will attend you. Oh, and one more thing. You will join me for dinner. That was not a request! Ugh!
And I quote,
the toast of
sage, the father of one little cell.
Wait, this is impossible.
I know it is, but here we are. Now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice. But let's see what I've got in my drawers. Oh, let's just get there. Ah, here we are. I wore this the night I was formed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there. Of course, I wouldn't have a prayer fitting into it now. Here, take it.
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Of course you are. We all heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is just happening so fast. It was a very brave thing you did, my dear. We all think so. I'm going to miss my papa so much.
Cheer up, child.
I know that you may think of it now, but you mustn't despair. We are here to see you through. I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then Bill, it's you. And who knows, you may fall.
That's bad.
But we don't have time. The roses already got the whip.
It's no use. She's so beautiful, and I'm... Well, look at me.
He has a point.
Master, you must help her to see past all that.
I don't know how.
Well, you could start by trying to make yourself a bit more presentable. Straighten up. Act like a gentleman.
Impress me, ignorant.
But be gentle.
I'll shower her with compliments.
But be sincere.
And above all... What?
You must control your temper.
Where is she?
Who? Oh, yes. The girl. Well, actually, she's in the process. Circumstances being what they are.
She's not coming. She's not coming!
What did you say?
She's not coming!
We'll see about that.
Your lordship, don't be scared. Let's not behave.
Say what you want. Lear, stay aside. I thought I told you to come down to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I'm telling you to come down to dinner.
And I'm telling you, I'm not hungry.
You're hungry if I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What did you say?
You can't go around ordering people to be hungry. It doesn't work like that.
I can't.
And besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude, is it? Well, how about this? If you don't come down to dinner, I will drag you by your hair.
Master, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affection.
Gentlemen.
But why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come down to dinner!
So, then, you're being a bully. Deep breaths, Master, deep breaths.
Okay. I will give her one last chance. Belle, would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please.
No, thank you.
Violet's gone!
That's the place!
If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat at all!
What were we thinking? We will never be human again.
So it appears.
Well, what would you two have us do? Give up? I won't give up till I hear the sound of my boy's laughter as he runs down these halls again.
Quite right, Mrs. Potts. We mustn't give up while there's still a chance. Mumia, stand guard at the door, and if there's the slightest change in it, form me at once.
I'll win, Captain.
I asked her nicely, but she refuses. What? What does she want me to do? Beg? Show me the girl.
Why should I? Did he give my father a chance?
No.
No, he wants to get to know him. I don't want to get to know him. I don't want anything to do with him.
You cut me to my wick. So you think a little thing like that would change? change my feelings for you, I mean, you really take over my thoughts.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh no, no, no. I've been hurt by you before.
I am a little hungry.
I'll wait for Mrs. Pop. What are we allowing? Wait.
That's all right. I'll go myself.
Are you sure the master's really not going to like this?
I know.
Oh dear.
Oh dear.
I like this girl. I like her funk.
Well, if you ask me, she was just stubborn. After all, he did say he is.
I think that may be the first time I've ever heard him use that word.
I believe you're right.
See, she's already starting to have a good influence on him. There you are, Jerry. Glad to see you out and about.
I am Carter, head of the household. If there's anything that we can use, just let us know.
Cogsworth! Cogsworth! The girl! She's gone! My eyes never... Oh! Enchanté.
This is Lumiere. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop that! If there's anything you can do to me, just say more fun calls. Anything, anything at all.
I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth!
Well, you heard what the master said.
Oh, pish tosh, I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
Fine. Glass water. Crest of it.
Cogsworth! I'm so pleased to you. She is not our prisoner.
She is our guest.
We must make her feel welcome here.
Fine, dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, it'll be our next.
Ah, yes. But what's dinner without a little music?
Music?
And by the most, this is the deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you here tonight.
So we invite you to relax, take this wooden chair.
As a dining room traveler corset.
Your dinner. Kiss. Be our guest. Put our service close yet.
Tie your napkin around your neck, Sherry. Provide rest to the shore.
At the nerves, but we only live to serve.
Try to grace them.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They both say, take a dance. After all this, this is France. And our dinner is worth those sacrifices. Go on, unfold your menu. Take a crossing, then you'll be our guest. We are guests. We are guests.
Eat ragu, she's to play. I'm good.
Try to sit with the crew of the
who is not serving, is not whole, and not a soul. So school days when we were in school. Saturdays, those good old days are gone. 10 years we've been rusting, living so much more than nothing. Getting exercise in a chance to use us. Most days we just lay around the castle. Black and black and lazy, you walk in and look so lazy.
Poppy!
Perhaps you'd like to take me?
I'm sure you know everything there is to know about the castle.
Well, actually, I do.
May I draw your attention to the terror brought to his life among the Nixon centaurs?
Act like a gentleman. Oh, this will be good. Belle? Belle?
Now, if you will note the unusual inverted archway, this is yet another example of the latest new classic Belle experience. As I always say, if it's not Belle, then it's now, may I draw your attention to the flying buttresses among the aviary?
Oh, the air is all so beautiful. I had no idea. If only you were here.
Act like a gentleman. I am nothing but a fool.
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted, and that was the last time a stone of that weight was ever quarried in this area. Ever again.
What's up there?
Nothing. Nothing at all of anything just in the west wing.
Ah, so that's the west wing.
Nice going!
I wonder what he's hiding up there.
Hiding? What an idea. Hiding.
Petted wouldn't be permitted, would it?
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. We have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back to the Aloysius of the Penches.
Maybe later.
Perhaps you'd like to see the garden or the library.
You have a library?
With books.
Oh, yes. Scab books, mountains of books, forests of books, flowers, cascades, swamps of books.
Books by every author who said pen to pen.
More books than you could ever read in a lifetime.
If I can't love her.
pretend that she loved me too. If I can't love her, then who? Long ago I should have seen all the things I could have been. Careless and unthinking, I move onward. No pain could be deep to run away if this wouldn't have happened.
If you hadn't frightened me, I would have run away.
Well, you shouldn't have been in the West Wind.
And you should learn to control your temper. Now hold still. This may sting a little. By the way, thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
Well, that's more like it. I knew they could get along if they tried.
So, the ice is broken at last. And not a moment too soon with the heavy chicken of the conversion. It's losing petals and a bobbing rain.
And not to mention the fact that he's hardly been here for its own.
Really, it is time to give him a little push. We must find the romantic way to draw some individuals.
I have just the thing. How about we warm you two up with a nice bowl of soup?
There's something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and not even fine. But now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't sleep there before.
Come on, dearie, let me try this one.
What I saw when we touched the lid shut like my paw. And me, I'll just ignore. But then she never met me. When she smiles at me, I get all choked up. My heart starts pounding and I can't breathe.
Good.
That's good?
That's excellent.
I've never felt anything about anyone. I want to give her something. But what?
Well, there's the usual things. Flowers, chocolates, promises you've given to me.
No, no, this is no ordinary girl. You must find something that sparks her interest.
Something to
what?
What?
Are you sure?
Well,
ahem.
Say something about it.
Hey,
a compliment.
Oh, well, what a nice dress.
Thank you.
Belle, I have something to show you, but you must close your eyes. It's a surprise.
Can I open them?
All right.
Mama?
Yes, Chip?
Will I ever get to be a boy again?
I hope soon. If it's to be, it will be very soon. Come along.
Knowing not that this indeed was the legendary sword called Excalibur, Arthur tried to pull it from the stone. He tried once, to no avail. He tried a second time, but still he could not pull from the stone. Then, for the third try, Arthur drew forth the sword.
Then he must be king.
Wait and see.
Wow, I didn't know books could do that.
Do what?
Take me away from this place and let me forget for a little while.
Forget?
What I am.
We have something in common, you know.
What's that?
In the town where I come from, the people think I'm odd.
You?
So I know how it feels to be different. And I know how lonely that can be. Then, for the third try, Arthur drew forth the sword, and there from the people arose a great shout. Arthur is king.
Told you so.
Hello, Mama.
like it, I'd like to ask you for something.
What's that?
A second chance. Will you dance with me tonight?
Dance? Me? You? That means I mean, oh yes!
Upon that alone, I'll leave. She adores the old good food. She'll be forced to be compliant.
She'll dare to your food.
We get the daughter through her dad. You just pronounce the old myself entirely clear.
Find the courage and take the chance.
Master, look at the robes. There's so little time left.
I really don't think I can do this. Here, take this. It might help bolster your courage. You can do it, Master. I know you can.
Just a little change. all to say the least, both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast. Ever just the same, ever a surprise.
Thank you.
Grandpa. I thought I'd never find you.
But the beast, how'd you escape?
I didn't escape. He let me go.
He let you go? That terrible beast?
But he's not terrible. At first, I was so frightened, and I thought it was the end of everything. But somehow, things changed.
How?
I don't know, but I see him differently now. It's funny, when I look around, I see the whole world differently.
There's been a change in me, a kind of moving on. The one I used to be, I still depend upon. For now I realize that good can come from bad, that may not make me wise. But oh, it makes me glad and
fine! Have it your way! take, old man.
No. No, let go of me. Let go of me, Belle.
Wait! I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast.
That's him. That's him.
Is he dangerous?
Oh, no. He can never hurt anyone. I know he looks frightful, but really, he's kind and gentle. He's my friend.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you have feelings for this monster.
He's not the monster, Gaston. You are!
She's as crazy as the old man. She thinks this monster's her friend. Well, I've hunted wild beasts. I've seen what they can do. Beasts protect your children. They'll make off with them in the night.
I would never do that.
Forget the old man. I say we kill the beast.
Yeah! Until he's dead, he'll come starving us at night.
Sacrifice our children to this monster's appetite.
Bang, with a sharp one. beast. Belle is mine.
No!
Was it?
Yes, it was.
no, it wasn't.
It most certainly was.
No, it wasn't, Lumiere.
Yes, it was.
Lumiere, I tell you that that is
not... Not if that was the plan.
That is not the plan.
Yes, it was.
You look so much better.
What do you mean? I thought you liked me the way I looked before.
I did. It's just I like you better this way, you know.
Can you remind me?
No, I wasn't.
Yes.
No, I wasn't.
Yes.
Okay, well, maybe a little.
I like you better this way, too.
Did you know I wore this tonight at the ball in the royal?
Thank you.